What I don't get here is he's the highest paid goalkeeper in the world. And he's the highest paid goalkeeper in the world because his contract was expended, correct me if I'm wrong, extended a year ago. And the thinking at the time was that, well, if you don't extend his contract, you lose him on a free. You can't sell him because nobody wants to buy him because he makes too much money already. So let's extend him and keep him around.
That can't be true.
Well, am I wrong, Mark?
No, you extend the contract because you think he's very good and he earns, you know, he deserves that money, and you want to keep him because he's...
But the argument is because you can't sell him, if you don't extend his contract, then you have to go and spend 60, 80 million on all black or whatever. I mean, is that a fair summation, Mark, or am I being unfair?
Surely. You don't keep
It is a fair summation, but I think United called it wrong last year. I think we've all seen De Gea decline slowly at first, but I think quite rapidly since the World Cup in 2018. He's not had a good 2 years. And, you know, that mistake he made for the second goal on Sunday, it was identical to the mistake he made at Tottenham in the first game after the restart. Shot straight at him, couldn't hold on to it. And he's making the same mistakes repeatedly. And I think this is beginning to remind me what happened to Joe Hart at Man City, a goalkeeper who got himself into a comfort zone, thought he was better than he is. And the mistakes were always the same mistake, down low to his left. And it's the same with De Gea, straight through his body, low to his left, always tried to save with his feet. And I've said this so many times now, I think he's an outdated goalkeeper. I think that, you know, Oblak is a great goalkeeper. Alisson, Ederson, Ter Stegen, Neuer, they've all left him behind because they're prepared to play a different way. They'll take command of the penalty area. They'll come out of the penalty area. De Gea, like I said, he's been in a comfort zone for too long. And I think Solskjaer now has to make a big call. And everyone talks about he's a Fergie clone. He does what Sir Alex Ferguson used to do. Well, Ferguson dropped Jim Leighton, Fabian Barthez, Massimo Taibbi, yeah, Mark Bosnich, Tim Howard. He was ruthless with goalkeepers.
Yeah, but with all due respect, Mark Bosnich is Australian, Tim Howard's American, Massimo Taibbi, I don't know what planet the guy's from. I mean, it takes a lot more chutzpah here to go and drop the guy you just made the highest paid goalkeeper in the world.
But Arteta dropped Ozil, so why can't Solskjaer do it? It's exactly the same.
No, I think the big difference is that Ozil's contract expires in 12 months.
But last year was the same. Emery dropped him as well. But I don't get that, Gav. I'm sorry. He's not good enough. Drop him regardless of the money he's on.
I'm not saying you should never be dropped, but I want to go back to because I think we need to flag these mistakes that were made before. I know we've been hard on Woodward. I've been maybe more accommodating towards Woodward than some other people. But this is what bugs me about the decision. I understand, as we said before in the summary, why you felt you had to extend De Gea's contract, right? Because it was objectively hard to sell him because the decline had already started. His reputation outside England wasn't what it was within England, and there weren't that many other big clubs who could afford him when he needed a goalkeeper. I get that. You hardball him and you say, listen, we'll give you a new contract, but you know what? We're going to cut your wages because he was already in enormous wages. Or we're going to do this on our terms. If you want to become a free agent and you want to go test yourself out there, good luck. Go see where you go. Go enjoy your time in China. Go enjoy playing for some, you know, Europa League team. Have fun at Roma or Valencia or wherever your agent takes you. That's when you had to go hardline to him. Show us, you know, I'd like to see more from clubs doing this. Show us that you're the keeper you were before, because you've not been playing up to the contract and now you want a raise. And instead, they folded. And I think that was the mistake.
The thing is, clubs that do it from a position of strength, and United were particularly strong last year. They were in a bad place. They just lost Mourinho. Solskjaer had come in, and they weren't a club that was strong enough to do that. And I think there were similarities in this to what happened with Arsenal and Mesut Ozil. They made a call on Sanchez. They let Sanchez go. And I think when United gave De Gea the contract, they expected to lose Pogba at some point. So they couldn't, as Man United, club that projects itself to the biggest club in the world, they couldn't be seen to be losing two of their biggest stars at the same time. Now, obviously, situations have dictated that Pogba has remained. I think he will stay beyond this period. But De Gea, they're now stuck with him as Arsenal are stuck with Mesut Ozil, because, like you say, his wages are too big. There's not a market for goalkeepers right now in the world. The only club I could see that would be remotely interested would be Juventus, but I don't think they'll pay his wages.
They've got Chesney and Buffon.
I don't think Chesney's a goalkeeper. Why now? But what, 6 months ago? I don't think Chesney's a goalkeeper of Juventus standard.
But he's better than De Gea, you would not swap Chesney for De Gea.
The point I'm making, the fact that there's such a limited scope for him to go to, so they're stuck with him.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN+.